All right, U-boat it is. Hopefully that fan is not gonna like drive people crazy. It is so hot today. Too hot. Let's see where we left off last time. It is kind of like The Sims a little bit, just a wee bit, just a little more serious. See if any ships are around. Probably not. We're way behind me. Okay. It is U571. We'll like it. Just like it. See if they hear anything. Probably not.
Herr Kalor.
Doesn't seem like there's anything around. Let's see, I can't remember, I think it's almost morning. Maybe. Actually, I think that might be, yeah. Sun is almost coming up. Dumb and can't remember, maybe? It's the moon. Yeah, we were heading in tonight. Actually, it's looking like snow. snow. How far we gotta go? Oh, we got a ways. Yikes. Can't see Jack Squat. I think there's actually a setting. I guess not.
Auf Seerohrtiefe. Bestätigt. 20 Meter. Thank you.
nothing.
Wir sind schon so lange auf See. Ich halte es nicht mehr aus.
There we go.
Auf Seerohrtiefe.
Wechseln auf Dieselmotor.
good enough. That's a little fast. Thank you. listen if there's anybody around. Probably not.
Auf E-Motor.
Auf Seerohrtiefe. Jawohl. Jawohl.
Today.
Is everybody in the room? Wechseln auf Dieselmotor.
It's morning, I think, and it's raining again. Great. Snow, not rain. Good Lord. Jesus. two legs. Sheesh. Calm, I've seen her. It's like a lake, so calm. Literally never seen it like that. Very bizarre. Feeling it's gonna be really shallow. Nope, I was wrong.
Tauchen auf 50 Meter.
See what we hear, if anything. Probably not a whole lot. That's alright. Don't know that I have the energy this evening for like convoys and destroyer groups and everything else. It's been a long day. It's a lot. Sometimes you just want to cruise along and control yourself.
20 meter.
Nighttime, red lights. the rednecks driving by late at night again. July 4th weekend. Making all the noise. I cannot get over this water, like how calm. It was like eerie. So crazy. So crazy. Still just cannot get over the damn water. Like, how crazy. That is so bizarre. It's literally just like a lake. Absolutely nuts. Does that mean, like, when we get close to Bear Island, it's gonna be like a blizzard or something crazy in shallow water? Closer, still extremely calm. Not quite as much, but still very calm. There we go, now there's some actual waves. Calm though. Send a group to land, eh? Before we do that, we're gonna listen so I know what kind of situation we're in if S-word hits the fan. So I do believe it is extremely shallow here, like less than 50 meters. Yep, I was right. I was right. Right. Well, who do we want to send? New radio man. Maybe one of the engineers, I guess. If they had little speedboats like that, or if that's a little bit of an exaggeration. Either way, it's kind of fun. Team arrived at the coast with no problems. There's no sign of human presence around. We should send a scouting party to search for a good spot to deploy the weather station. Yes, you should. Can never get over how cruddy it is to be in such shallow water with such a massive sub.
Oi.
I think we're gonna give old Kurt a little shot of caffeine here. Keep him juiced up. Because we need you on lookout duty, sir. That's not where I wanted to go. Because we need to know if anybody comes skulking around. to date. Our scouting team found a good location to deploy the weather station and carried all components there. We can start assembling it. Assembling it? A little typo there, maybe? Question is, I lost track of what time. Should be about daylight, I believe. No, maybe not. Unless we went far enough east, it's a little later. Weather station, decoded message, temperature minus 4°C, wind speed 9 knots. Yeesh. Alright, so. Are we? Yeah, you guys are back on board. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Six days later. Thing is, that's an easy one. After that, it starts to get a lot tougher with the mission selection. Mine laying, spy runs, whatever you want to say, dropping spies off behind enemy lines. It's gonna be rough. German Cross. Horst Weber. think we had anybody, because we didn't sink any ships on that little run.
Dies sind die heutigen Aufträge von BDU. Streng geheim.
Probably back to the patrols, tonnage war, maybe? I think so. Thing is, this is the way you have to look at it to see kind of what your timeline is for these missions. This needs to be done by the end of June 1940. Enigma's got all the way until 42. Mine laying has until 41. Scapa Flow has until 42. So we're back to tonnage war, I think. So that is what we'll be focusing on. But first, we gotta resupply so I don't forget anything. I have slipped up on that in the past. On this one, we are stocking up like nobody's business. Just everything we can grab and buy, we're grabbing. Is pretty well topped off. I don't know that we can. We're gonna go ahead and get dive equipment, but I just don't know that I can even use it without that actual perk on a character. It's hard to say. What else do we need? Let's check and make sure the engineers have parts on them. They should. Yeah. He's got rebreathers. Weber does not. Med kits. You do not have any med kits. Let's get you taken care of there. Interesting. I didn't have any more on, eh? Make sure to grab those.
Show me.
I think that's literally about all we can squeeze into this can. Now, let's try to grab that mission just to patrol. We'll try to do it in some type of chronological order, plus patrols are typically a little slower paced, so it gives me a chance to still learn a bit, get a little better.
Dies sind die heutigen Aufträge von BDU. Streng geheim.
We are going to do, let's finish up our lower tier. Like I said, we'll try to keep them somewhat in a little order. Let's make sure the crew's topped out. Yeah, we're good. I don't think anybody leveled up on that one, no. I do have 4 points to spend, though. I don't think there's much I can do without sacrificing like a leader or engineer, though, which is really not ideal. Yeah, that's 41. 40 was toilets. Time? July 1st. Accumulators we can do, but again, that's sacrificing an engineer, which is a little rough. Um, 41 for ammunition. Hydrophone is 41. Well, let me click out of that, really. Torpedoes 40. Conning towers 41. So the only other thing is leader. I can't sacrifice that yet without... That's a month, too. Ooh. Yeah, I think we're going to hold off. We'll pass on this. So let's map ourselves a course to get into the grid there. And I'm going to go ahead and say that we're probably about ready.
Yeah, hello.
Get you guys grabbing supplies. Make sure not all the food's crammed in there at once so we don't blow through it. And I'd say we're about ready to head out. That's it. How that camera that forces the view and dock there. Can't zoom out. It's kind of shitty. Skim through this a bit. Choppy water already. Love it. Should probably give Weber's, when he's off duty, some of those rebreathers, because if shit hits the fan, that's the last thing I want to worry about him not having. And the bad weather's back. Actually, somehow I misjudged what time of day it was. Just heading into... still got a few hours, I think. Yeah, about another two. Loki. See, it's ingrained in my mind. I'm always going to call you Loki. No matter what. What's up? You guys playing some Diablo again tonight for the weekend? Turbo and everybody? I think it said Jake was playing earlier. I'm not sure if he's on there or what. Hopefully he's actually doing the campaign. That'd be nice. At the grid. Boom. Slow down a tinge. Here, if at all. 63 meters. Favorite bug in the game. Let's put that up just a tinge while they're doing that. Resize the old TDC. Just in case, because we're going to try to use it. Skim ahead just a tad.
Chance anblasen.
Right. Time to surface. Still nighttime for a couple hours, I believe. Forget to send him to get supplies when he's off duty. I want to take him off the engines right now, that's for sure. Get that compressor turned on. Say we're gonna head straight north. We'll go along the coast or close to it. Still clicking off. Yeah, air's good. Okay, we can move. We're looking a little choppy. Let's go just a tad. Stop again. Listen. Plenty of water.
Fishing there. 20 meters.
gosh, that is the worst pathing. Like, they have to fix that. I'm literally gonna be so sad if it's in there for the rest of eternity. Let's skip ahead just a few to start the surface process.
Wechseln auf Dieselmotor.
Let's get that on. Start moving here. Like to find just one or two ships even this patrol, I'd be totally content with. Like, doesn't have to be anything crazy. Let's just catch like a lone freighter or tanker or something. That would be awesome. I think we will. We're gonna go right along the top. So that's pretty in line with from like one port to another. So we might intercept somebody passing through. We shall see. Let's make sure that, yeah, compressor's on. Perfect. Gotta make sure. Oh boy, what do we get? Lone steamer. Smoke cloud spotted somewhere in a naval square AN516. Slow speed northern course. Pursuing typo, I'm guessing. Other target. 516. What the hell is that? Excuse me. 516. So he could be. Let's see if we can get down there nice and quick. We'll go ahead and give her a try. Lone ship's an easy target. Listen. Let's see if we can pick this dude up. This dude. Meters, a little more shallow than I was expecting. we can hear anybody.
Jawohl. Jawohl. 20 Meter.
20. We're close enough if he was still actively heading north, but it's really hard to say. Literally could be anywhere. Could have changed direction. Could have. I mean, we got to where we needed to be roughly to even pick him up.
50.
We're gonna see. It's got to be somewhere. That would be on our starboard side, I believe. Believe if we're not going to be able to pick him up. I hate those radio transmissions. I feel like they're always so hit and miss. Sometimes it's like right on the money, other times it's like not even in the same vicinity. I mean, I would say at this point, our next best bet. Probably to just head We're still a ways off. It's possible he's outside that bubble, but man, we have pretty good hydrophone range. I really don't think we're that far away. Speed up our little listen here, get surfaced, refill the air tanks, and we'll beat feet south. There's other ports along that coast. Let's get that kicked on.
20 Meter.
Wechseln auf Dieselmotor.
Going to hammer down.
Thank you.
that compressor kicked on. Yeah, I think he just did, right as we said that. Perfect. Listen ourselves. Let's make sure it's not deep. Make sure it is deep here. Jet, what's up, sir? How's your evening going? Nice holiday weekend, hey? Just do it ourselves, have a little quick listen. Two false flag ships added to my tally today. Very nice. Chalk them up. Done this stream has we finished up our easy mission to Bear Island for the weather station, stopped a couple times to listen, didn't find anything, knocked out the weather station and came home resupplied. Now we are just chipping away at our tonnage on patrol. Hitting the end mission button instead of patrol button. Oh no. Happens, man. It happens. Back at base now. Nice. I made sure to resupply nice and thoroughly for this patrol so we didn't forget anything dumb like spare parts and run low on food. We're nice and stocked. About as good as we can be. Hopefully we'll find some ships. Cannot believe we didn't hear this single freighter. Just not an accurate report, I guess. One day, 6 hours before hydro upgrade ready. Nice. Very nice. Crew needs vacation. Yeah. Might as well, man. Have them on nice and fresh, ready to go. Definitely don't think we are going to find this guy. But we'll listen for just a moment. Probably moving northeast when they told us north, and we probably missed them somewhere. Although we had good coverage with hydrophone, just wasn't in the cards on this one, I guess. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and surface, get moving again. Been a lot of torpedoes last time out. Only got two T2s, so I may have to visit the other ports to get them. There you go. That's a good problem to have, though, right? Lots of targets. I'm working on it. I can feel it. I'm gonna get close. Actually expending some. Let's get somebody on the compressor. And let's boogie ahead. Which patrol area? We are in one of the easier ones, like kind of where it starts you here between Norway and a little more boring, I guess, but still want to practice it a bit, kind of get some more mechanics down comfortably. That's where I am. Some of my old save files, I went to some of those other areas. It definitely gets a hell of a lot busier. So want to get some basics down for myself with the TDC before I get into those big convoys with escorts and whatnot. Let's see. You're probably on the western side, I believe, I would assume at this point. Or probably even in a totally different area. Celtic Sea, last two patrols. Okay. Just a tad. Ten wrecks marked. Wow. You got a lot to check out. Worried they may disappear. Yeah. That's smart to mark them, though. Gives yourself a chance to check. Little tricks like that I pick up from you guys. Try to remember. If I vacation, yeah, it's a good idea. What'd we get? Single steamer, naval square AN168. Speed 7 knots, course 173. Two duds, one miss, couldn't counterattack. Wow, that's some bad luck with the torps there. 168. Let's see where the hell that is. It's heading south. We have found ourselves on the wrong side of pretty much all of these. Let's, so hot and humid here, my computer acts like it's going to take off when I play. It is very toasty here. During the beginning of the stream, it's been kind of quiet tonight, but I said that I hope my fan in the background's not picking up on my mic, or at least too badly, because man, it's extremely humid here as well. It is way too rough to not have air moving inside. Like, we have been socked with just humidity all day. Rain too, but not enough to break, you know, and cool anything. It's just kind of making it like miserable rainforest. That's good. It's pretty good mic, so I hoped it wasn't picking up. I would watch the feedback, but you never know, volume levels. We got our moms planted today, so it was a long day. I just wanted some chill U-boat. 210 planted today. We are still under thunderstorm watch, I think. Yeah, we have our thunderstorms. I actually just poked in and checked the weather here like within the last 20 minutes, and it tells us that we are expecting around like wee hours of the morning, like 3-4 a.m. So we'll see. It's been rain on and off all day today, though. Some virtual farming. That's the next best thing, man. High demand barley. Okay. It's pretty fun. We're gonna boogie pickups pace. They were only moving 7 knots reported. Let's see. Sugar beets. That's some interesting stuff. I don't know as much about like that cotton, you know, stuff they typically grow in different climates. Cottons, I know mainly in the South still. It's pretty cool though how they harvest that stuff. There's some specialty equipment. It's pretty neat. Square AN155, course 39 degrees, 7 knots. That one we probably don't want to pursue. Check where 155 is, yeah. I'm not worried about that at the moment. Had sail on the equipment, so I am ready to do beets and potatoes now. Potatoes are very cool too. I've actually seen how potatoes are harvested, like IRL. We grow them, you know, just small stuff here for us, like in our raised beds. But it's very cool to see them like harvested large scale, you know, like on a farm out in a field. It's really cool. It's nice. It's awesome to grab the equipment for sure. Very cool. Picked up another officer in Uboat, so good day, I reckon. Nice. I was doing some research on the missions to see like who you get for what missions. It's definitely great when you get that the extra help. Looking forward to it for sure. Up here just a tinge. I gotta check the food situation. Cross training your officers. That's cool. Have them be able to handle some other additional roles. It'd be super handy for sure. Let's get, speaking of officers, we need to get Mr. Weber and grab some. Ah, that's why I'm at the wrong storeroom, duh. So we gotta go to the, no. Yeah, right there in front of me, duh. Want them to have rebreathers in case the proverbial stuff hits the fan. Keep them safe. Like get a radio officer experience, then promoting him to leader so he can do both. That's cool. Not sure if it will work or not. Hell yeah, give it a shot. Good trick to do if it does work, right? Leader that can do medic and hydro. That's great. Fantastic. Let's pump the old brakes here and listen. Even though it is nice and clear, I want to see if I can pick them up maybe further away. Don't know why I still have red lights on. So I think it will work again, hopefully. I bet you could probably do it. It sounds pretty logical, you know, to try to, like you said, cross-train them and get the benefit of both. It's a good idea. Good little trick. We are golden. Let's have a listen. Now the trick is to not get them killed. Amen. See if we can pick this guy up. I really want to find at least one. build on something a little bit. These radio contacts haven't seemed to be very reliable. There we go. Ooh. It's really that far behind? Yikes. Oh, I should have listened a little sooner. Let's see if we can get just a rough pinpoint here. Sure doesn't look like 173 to me. Granted, I'm not precise on those dots. But hey, what are you going to do? Well, what we're going to do is go out. That part will adjust once we see how far ahead we can get. Let's confirm the attack scope is the best scope for magnification. Good to know. Yeah, I think you guys pretty much told me that was the suspicion, and I think we one attempt, it maybe when I was off stream, I kind of played with the other and definitely seemed like you couldn't get a very good view in comparison. Let's go ahead and speed this puppy up. As soon as we surface, we will hammer down and see if we can get up ahead of him. Alright. So that's going to get us on our way up. As long as we make sure we get moving and get the old compressor on.
20 meter.
This is a little lone freighter, so assuming it's hostile, we will get some good practice in. I'm going to attempt to do my best to use the old TDC. Start to get a little comfortable with it and at least try it. The surface trick that I've been using by having all 3 liters on scopes when identifying, figuring torps, etc. I know in the past, like when I really first started playing, I was pretty much relying on them to like help plot the courses and whatnot, because you know, when you're new, and I'm still relatively new, you know, it's a lot to remember and not forget the little things in the background as well, which I still do. Braver than I with that thing. It's not that bad, man, I'm telling you. We're gonna figure it out. You'll get some practice here, we'll get an attempt, and then if I mess it up, you don't have to worry about it, right? Try to get up ahead of this guy, because I blew the positioning on it for sure. So hopefully he just keeps trugging along nice and slow. Let's get that sent. I sure don't see that funnel smoke just rotating around free cam. It's on the fringe of our visibility, maybe. Oh, there it is. You can barely see it. That looks like more than one. Unless it's just trailing because we're moving pretty fast, maybe that could be. No, I just don't trust the mods that much. Seen too many weird crashes and saves not working. I've already had some weird crashes on the last, you know, not last couple streams, but like last month, and then the other night, last time I was on Uboat a few nights ago. Could be. Might be from the mods. Could have been my PC. I don't know. I should be checking the temps and everything. I'm water cooled, so I doubt that it's hot enough. It's causing crashes and we never lost the stream. It just kind of hard crashes out of the game. Could be the mod. I think with mods, it definitely strikes me as it's better to have them already on and set up for the save file. I think bouncing in and out of them in a save file is like no bueno. So that could be my problem. Maybe that's what's causing my grief. I definitely can understand weird crashes and save files getting goofed. We're gonna try to... I think we'll be okay. We're gonna... Oops, that's not what we want to do. We're just gonna head parallel. Actually, I guess we don't need to be that far out, huh? Actually, what am I doing? Making it overly complicated. We're just gonna go ahead. Keep her nice and easy. Solo ship. It should be a solo ship. That's all they picked up on the radio transmission. So, we are gonna give her a go. That is a good question. I see on my old save file, my Kurt Hoffman here, the whatever we'd like to call him, I guess the technical term for his on-boat title, was actually like had the dive perk like on his skill tree. This one does not, and none of my other like officers do. So I don't know, like we have the equipment loaded up, but I don't know, like, will it let me dive without that perk, or is the perk just maybe like a benefit? We might try it, but I almost guarantee maybe it's, I feel like it's not gonna let you. Let's see. Still cooking. That seems a little more in line than our initial little reference point. Leaders and mechanics can wear the suit, no issues. Good to know. Okay. Yeah, maybe we'll check it and see. We are, last little depth check, we're in pretty deep water, so I don't know that it's doable, but we'll give her a check for sure. Since there's only a lone ship, we got the time. You know me, I like to play slow. There's our smoke. Goodies are so awesome. I remember you or Amanim or maybe both of you guys mentioned at different times that you found, I think it was you told me you got like a ton of food off of a dive from one of the ships, I believe. It's definitely pretty cool to find anything like that. Oh, let's see. Probably want to slow her down a tinge. Don't know why I just clicked diesels when we're already on diesels. I think what we're going to do... whole ship's worth. That's awesome. Giving it for that free XP. That's right. Let's pull up the old TDC here. As long as I remember, there's only a few things you really have to remember on that. And I believe that... this, and it's gonna autofill. We're gonna give her our best go. Seven command points, nice. We've got quite a few stashed away right now. We're sitting at 4, but it's still kind of tough for me to decide to leave like a leader or engineer behind. It's going to be such a struggle for me without that extra hand. So maybe I'll hold off for a bit till we get the extra officer availability. I'm going to do a little cheat sheet here and pull up the TDC. Let's the old good old Steam community has their good little tidbits on there. You would think as many times as I've used some of the videos for the TDC that I would remember, but you know, it's easy to forget that stuff when you have busy days. It's all right, we can cheat a little bit and watch. Right now, up a tad because he's moving 7 knots, give or take. We don't want to get left too far out. We gotta get closer. Also, too, your officer's got a new award today. Gold U-boat badge with diamond. Wow, nice. Very cool. It's pretty. They got the fancy badge. Fancy medals. Let's see. It really looks like he's veering off course a tad. Not really, I guess. Like I said, I keep looking at my reference line there, which is way off, so it's definitely not. He's probably heading exactly about 173 degrees. My line's got him closer to like 190. It's all right. I want to take it nice and slow so I don't blow past him. What I really want to do, captain is only a 7 skill, hoping to see how far he can get. Hell yeah. Well, with patrols like that, you're going to be on the quick path to ranking him up pretty quickly there. Let's see if I can open this. Little TDC mod here. It would be much easier to watch the video, but for the sake of audio, there we go. There's a German streamer and his crew is sick. They have everything. He has been playing for a long time, I think. I have had a hard time, maybe just the time of day I've been poking around on the Twitch, but have not really come across anybody that I really like the stream. I think I found one guy was playing a little earlier on, so maybe it's like a new save file or whatever, but he was playing in French. But he also didn't say much during the stream, so it was pretty quiet most of the time. That's cool. Definitely cool to watch the veteran people. Can we see this dude? Probably not quite yet. Yeah, he's still a ways off. it's old, you are gonna hop on the boat just a tad stabilized, and maybe I'll be able to get a peek at this guy. I don't know though. Can't get the old boat stabilized, it might be a little tough. He's not there yet. He also speaks some English if you ask him to. Well, that's cool. Even better. Ragulosaur 1979 is a streamer name. Nice. I will check him out for sure. Still bobbing and weaving quite a bit. It's kind of a pain in the arse. Forget that for now. I think he has a tube channel as well. Cool. Even better. Close the distance on this guy. Let's go ahead and not quite there yet. Ragulosaur 6294. Okay. Thank you. I will check him out. Closer, quicker. And while we're doing that, so on this puppy, his editing is also very good. That makes it so much more fun when you're watching the videos. Like, I know that Wolf Pack, that he streams some other games aside from Uboat, but his editing's really nice. I love it. In U-Boat, he uses the cinematic camera quite a bit, kind of edits together little looks from inside, outside the ship while he's doing stuff. It's really neat. Very cinematic, for sure. Yeah, Wolfpack 345 or something like that. His YouTube channel is pretty good. I like it anyway. So, for the TDC, let me refresh my little memory here. This is our target speed. Our distance is gonna be right here. Torpedo speed, if needing changing, is going to be right there, but to change it, it's this button, I believe, and then it just displays in this inner little dial. He's a great skipper. Yeah, I watch a lot of his videos for sure. Find him very entertaining. Angle on bow. Yeah, I think we can do this with the old TDC. Like I said, it's gonna be a little goofy with me kind of bouncing back and forth, but we're gonna get her worked out here. We will get her worked out. All right, there's our guy. Let's go ahead and put old Mr. Hoffman on him just to get some extra information. Need to get him a little closer, don't I? A little updated line here for our own sake so I don't lose my mind with my wonky first guess here. Take her nice and slow. Speed her up. We're still a ways out. Doing that, I'm gonna look at my chart here, make sure I'm not missing anything aside from getting the old firing solution. Alright, let's give her a go here. Let's see where we're at. ...65%. Slow down a tinge. 7,000 meters. That could be a neutral, am I correct? It's Norway. So I can't directly fire on this guy. We have to probably interact with him. Or inspect, I guess. That kind of sucks. I swear, every time we get these opportunities early on, it's like just massive pain in the arse.
Yeah.
Frustrating. Inspect him, yes, then follow. If he's heading to an English port, he is fair game. Good idea. I mean, he is on the English side. We're heading there, so unless he's heading south and turning into Rotterdam here, or I doubt he's going to go further east, but yeah, if he cuts anywhere west on us here or heads down Port of London, he's going to get cooked. Odds are you can take him, yeah. Let's, I guess we're just gonna worry about getting closer now. So.
Stand up.
Just need to verify, yep. I guess, let's just get a bit closer. Woo-hoo-hoo. A little wide on the old turn there.
Legen Sie den Kurs an. Legen Sie den Kurs an.
He's still a ways away. We gotta get up closer. We'll talk to them, but it's not going to do us much good. I know that when you talk to them, they pretty much just say, oh, we're not doing anything sketchy. Who do we want to send over there? Last Bear Island we did. Weber, Captain, let's do Nod. Some XP here. Yeah, see what the cargo is. We're gonna check them out.
What do you need, officer?
Gilbert Walker. Ship is headed to the Port of London and is carrying utilities. It seems that this ship is trading with blockaded Allied ports and it's fair prize for you to sink it. He's getting cooked. I just guess we're just using the deck gun instead. Let's get the old guys back on board here. Actually, I don't know why I took them off. We're just gonna put them on the deck gun. that. Here we go. That'll work. I think she's going down. That HP on the old health bar is disappearing. Oh, it was. Now it's literally going to have one little air pocket. It's going to keep it above water. Oh, there it goes. Okay. Perfect. All right. Let's, that one's cooked. Any officers on board? Nope. Gotta check the other. Just one. I guess we'll be try to be a little nice and get give them a little bit of food, just a little. Ah, I already did the first. Sucker went down quick, took on water, and she was out of there. All right, well, let's move back to somewhat of a patrol route and see if we find anybody else. We're still early in this. Getting myself too hyped to use the old TDC. At least I paid enough attention. It was somebody I couldn't or shouldn't have just blindly shot at. Smoke there. Disappeared pretty quickly, though. Probably already out of range. Might want to stop and listen, although it's going to pick up that mess behind us, I think. Good that we got the tonnage we needed for the first tier there, but I wouldn't mind getting some extra practice. I don't think we can see whatever that smoke was that we caught a glimpse of. Just out of range, wherever it was. That's all right. probably check the old food sitch for the guys. That's cool. Hydrophone.
Herr Kaloy.
Be perfect timing. I'll let them have their little 5 minutes on the hydrophone, and I'm gonna grab a little drink here, IRL. Plenty of depth. Perfect. Guys, we're gonna let them listen for a second. I am going to grab a drink.
Wechseln auf E-Motor.
Auf Seerohrtiefe.
Back. Let's see. Heard something, huh? Oh, we got one to our east. This guy's heading 353, 7 knots, And this is 248, 7 knots. Well, both of them appear to be single. Let's see what we can do here. Keep these just for some sort of reference point for a sec. Far enough for me to worry about plotting another point. What I will do though is, let me say this was 353, so he's very much heading north. Let's see what we can do. Something like this, just to get us a bit closer, and that was 7 knots. Yeah, both were, I believe. Perfect. Compressor kicked on, perfect. Sun. Oh, let's see. Like spilling a little water right on your face. IRL. We're gonna do this manually. Heading under, let's see what they find.
Wechseln auf E-Motor.
Hopefully. Hopefully we hear that. Surely we will. There's somebody. That's our other guy. Heading a little more our direction, our neck of the woods. Like to see this guy somewhere. That's probably our other one. Let's see. Ooh, we got somebody else too. All single ships. Perfect. 353. See, that's another one where it's like the positioning is definitely not uber accurate, along with the fact that the markers probably aren't either, but. Seven knots. That guy's still seven knots. That's another one heading super north. Well, check her out. Since we're doing this manually, though, I was gonna say we can get a better fix on him this time without the 5-minute shuffle. That's a little better. First little goofy point. Get ourselves a little somewhat of a little direction here. And I would say go ahead and probably be lying in wait for him. Or close enough, rather. That may have been a bit more accurate there. And this gentleman, give him one more, a couple little minutes, plot another spot. Like to try to get at least three, I guess. Makes me feel a little more confident. That one's probably pretty on the money. Let's see. Not terrible. I would believe that. Next question is going to be just where are we going to be when we, this one we might be able to actually intercept somewhere further down the line here. This guy we should be okay. This one I have no idea if we get really eager here and try to engage multiple by the time we get to where we're getting. I want to check one last thing. This guy to the south. He's seven knots as well, suspected anyway. All right, well, let's go ahead and surface, and we're gonna get moving here.
20 Meter.
Oh, that walking bug. I can't stand it. It's so annoying. So annoying. Alright, we are on the surface. Let's get the compressor on and get moving. Might be able to spot some smoke here, assuming that we didn't let him get that far north of us, but at 7 knots, I can't imagine that he literally outran us even through the time compression. Ooh, he is a little further than I expected. Oh shit. It's crazy. The time compression is so misleading to me, I guess. Need to use less of that. Empty the cleaning boxes under tasks, white hat, no more walking in place, sailor. Oh, I see what you're saying, like on the, it goes away all the time, it's just every now and again, it like pops up, and it's just, I kind of laugh at it, I mean, just when it happens, it's like, really? Like, he's just stuck on the Christmas tree, just robot walking in place. It's goofy. Always goes away though, so I guess I can't complain too much. I just like to laugh at it, seeing him look like a goofball. Alright, well, the issue here is he got a little further north of us. I'd like to stay at a somewhat decent angle to him. Problem's gonna be if I go in at that angle, we're gonna be oops. That is one we can take though. No, it's not. Damn. Another neutral that we're just gonna have to get right up beside. It's the only bad thing, I guess, about early in the war is, like, most of these you're going to encounter. Parallel them to stay ahead, then close. I guess both of our ideas get thrown to the wind there. We're just going to have to get up by them and have our little chit-chat. And this one might be a little harder, too, because of the direction he's heading. It's very possible he's headed up to Bergen. So to decipher where he's coming from might be tougher. Check the next one then. We could do that. Let's see if we can nab this guy. No, I know they go to Bergen, but again, I don't know. I guess it's a spur of the moment decision, right? Like, we have to get close to him enough to talk, and then at that point just try to decipher the best we can what he's actually doing. Pick picked up more smoke up there, huh? 248. Interesting, interesting. Might get a little more chaotic here. At this point, we just need to get close enough. Get closer. No, it's a... No? It is English confirmed, but we don't know much beyond that, huh? So I guess we are gonna forget this guy. Let's try to... This isn't going to be perfect, but I want to give myself some sort of reference. How quickly is he moving? We don't know yet. Say that. It's irrelevant, right? Just now thought I probably shouldn't have went to Periscope already. We're gonna lose all that speed. Let's we're gonna say forget that and surface. No reason to trudge along at 7 knots barely and burn up the electric while he's clipping right along. Let's just surface and get after him. Still got a couple hours, I think, before it gets light. Solution on the thing. 60%. My little cheat sheet, see if I can remember. Gotta do get That's what we're doing right now. Perfect timing, Jet. Really was hoping to figure this out. Target speed. They have that other stopwatch added there for the TDC mod, I believe, but it is a little differently used. So until I can wrap my head around some of that stuff, we're gonna have to wait a bit. He is alarmed. Oh, this isn't good. I was trudging along so fast, worrying about. We're gonna have to rely on our solution. All right, you get some help, wrap up that torpedo so we can at least get one out there. Rookie stuff. Almost done with that maintenance. Problem is that ship is changing course quickly. Yikes. This isn't gonna go well again. Turned into him a tad, but we might throw it off now.
Nose!
My dumb self, too much speed, just charging in there, and he saw us clear as day. Wee hours of the night into the morning. Good news is, I don't know that he's gonna get that big brick turn quickly enough. No wonder he saw me, God, how close.
Der Torpedo ist auf halbem Weg zum Ziel.
We're gonna see what happens. Watch, it's gonna dud. It's gonna dud. That other ship's still just right there. We could go up and at least inspect. Them. Let's not run into this guy. They have not evacuated yet. He's got a sliver of HP left. Surely he's going to take on water here. Literally still clipping along. Gotta love it. he's got to be flooding. That bow is like coming up out of the water. Light on the nose. Swear, I'm not gonna be able to live if this guy just is gonna creep like this. Like, are you kidding me? Nose of the ship, the bow is like up out of the water. Oh, now they're leaving it. There we go. Got it. We'll take it. Again, a little messier than I was hoping, but it was my own overambition. Let's, no officers on lifeboat 1, 2, we'll take them, and we will give them supplies. That's one. Let's head over and give this supposed neutral a little poke here and see what's going on.
Course auf diese Koordinaten setzen.
7 knots. It's not gonna matter. We can't torpedo him. We just have to go be cordial. Now, let's go ahead and cancel the old alarm.
Alarm! Abgebrochen!
And we will get another engineer to bring up a torp.
Bewegung, los, schneller!
Yeah, I needed to pay more attention to the range and when I could have engaged safely, slowed down, and possibly gone to even periscope depth. With the first light coming up, I was going to be too easy to see, and I charged right in there. That's all right. Right now, this guy's like bobbing and weaving, thinking we're just gonna torpedo him. Not gonna do that, pal. Plus, I don't wanna ram into your ship here. Oh, good lord. I got a little sketchy close here. Little closer than we wanted to with the old time compression. Let's go ahead and talk to this cat. Let's go ahead and play that safe so we don't ram into him. Let's go ahead and send old Capitan. Just have a little chat, see what we can find. I have a feeling this one's not going to be easy to tell. Todd Frost, what a name. You asked the captain. Directed at Port of Bergen and transports utilities. If these documents are correct, the ship is not involved in a war effort, and sinking it could lead to a diplomatic incident of some degree. Yeah, the navigation skill, Jet. I had it in one of my previous playthroughs. None of my guys have it right now. I have, like, the worst perks. Like, they're, like, cooking and this and that. So I think we're kind of screwed on this one. But thank you. I don't think we can, yeah, can't do anything for this. Gotta let him go. Could have done probably, I don't know, I didn't pay attention to the prompt there, I guess, or in hindsight, but I was gonna say we might have been able to, like, check the cargo hold, but the time it would have taken, and probably be better off just pursuing one of the other ships. So, our other one was this guy. We can peel off and see where we can get here. On engine here. Gonna be a good angle, that's for sure. See what we pick up here when he crosses into our sight. One, let's go ahead and actually try to be a little smart so I don't go blazing face in here. What we are gonna do is get ourselves angled a bit better and try to let him come to us. Let's try to be smart about it, eh? Ourselves turned a little more east and west, and then if we have to, maybe we'll just even back her up a tad. We'll just sit and wait, let him come into our killing zone. That's what we're gonna try. Worst case scenario, we do what we end up doing a lot of times. When I goof up, we'll just bust out the deck gun. About reverse, I cannot recall. Will it pull the ship around? Yep, it totally is. Damn it. How did I know it?
Aye, aye, Herr Kaloy.
There we go. I knew it would do that. Just keep on going just a tad. Let's get another point. Oops, that's not what we wanted either. I'm not trying to charge the battery at periscope depth, eh? That's a little better. Feeling a little more confident about that. Now, what we need, though, we're nice and not visible. So, love that little goofy flag sticking up that I should have just put away. Let's put the other engineer on depth keeping. Keep us nice and stable. So, let's get you. There he is. I would say we got definitely not the tower. I want to say it's that explorer. Let's see if I can figure this out. We're gonna try our best to use our fancy little mod. Target speed of target ship and knots on the outer ring. Yeah, the inner ring is for torpedo if you adjust that. So with that being said, what I say that was maybe 6 knots. We're gonna go just about there. And then we still need to get a course, so let's practice our skills there. Skills, lack thereof, right? Oh. Gotta go pretty much from here to here and then out. Actually, you know what? Before we even do that, what I should have done Basics here. Basics, man. Gotta pay attention to the little things. Now, 18 degrees, and he is gonna be... distance, which first I guess let's plot that angle on our little TDC here, and target bearing angle, yeah, angle on bow. So we want to go, it's going to be right here. And what I say that was in our comes out to roughly, roughly 18 degrees off his bow. So let's turn. Somehow I don't think that's right. It's angle on bow. It should be that, but I definitely don't think I set it right. Should be that. It's measured from I think we had the right idea. I just was thinking that didn't display. I thought it actually. It's probably about right. We're gonna give her a go and do what we can. Is our distance, which we'll go ahead and do as best we can here with our little ghost tool. Pretty terrible. Now, let's say 2.2 kilometers. To get that other torpedo warmed up, which is going to be tricky with him on depth keeping. I don't know that I can put... Yeah, those guys can't do it. I'm going to put you on there, since we're not really moving. Let's get our other plot here for distance. Really gonna give this a try, whether it goes well or not. Distance is the dial here. So it's gonna be... Question is, how in the hell? I did not realize that that was in hectometers, which is slightly pain in the arse, right? So a hectometer is a tenth of a kilometer. So we would need 22, assuming that I'm relatively close to what we figured. Somewhere in there, like so. And then the only other thing I think that we need to make sure, I believe this switch controls bow and stern torpedo. The question is, which one is the proper... Yeah, so we want it to the switch to the left is bow. For our purposes right here, that would be stern or aft, whatever. All right, well, he's about ready to warm that up. Hopefully he's gonna get that done ASAP. Oh my gosh, you guys are gonna take forever. We'll just butcher one torpedo here on our calculations, and then if it botches it, we goof something up, then we will then we'll maybe let the computer figure up the solution for us. You gotta use a torpedo or two, I mean, come on. While they're doing that, I should probably check. Make sure. I don't think there's too much else that is critical, excuse me, to firing. I think those are the main parameters, with everything else being kind of optional for spreads, etc. Orange parameters are only for specific torpedo settings. The ones highlighted in blue are for target bearing and course deviation. And then I think we are ready to give her a go. So what we're gonna do is grab this baby. Fill her up. Let's see what we get. 79 degrees.
Rohr 1 bewässert.
Yeah, we might. We should have let him get a little further ahead of us. Has not been alerted yet. What we are going to do though is put we'll see. That was still a little bit of a slip up of mine. I should have let that angle get a little more appropriate. He was still a little far out there. We might end up whizzing this past him, especially with our calculation on that TDC. Oh yeah, we missed. Damn. Kidding. Alright, well, that's because I sped it up after making the calculation, so angle was off.
Torpedo ausrichten.
Well, as soon as that maintenance is done, we will see if we can get another one launched at least and take him down. Somehow he did not see that torpedo either, which is hilarious. Maintenance is almost done. This one should be a little more appropriate. A more appropriate angle. I think they did see it. Doesn't say they're alarmed. I mean, I would think they would have too. Maybe just because it's at night somehow they missed it. It was a T2. Our alarm's on, but that was auto-triggered just because of the country identification, but theirs isn't showing up for, like, alert. Yeah, it's just heard by hydrophone and visually detected. I think so far they don't know. So we did luck out at least in getting another. They're just now calling that a miss, really, guys? This other one's aimed right at the, it's either gonna dud or smack right into it. That'll do. issues is it doesn't look like that took as big of a chunk of their health as I was quite hoping. Let's see here. Let's get another maintenance. Mr. Nod. I should have just went ahead and kept him on maintenance, but hey. Yeah, we're gonna give it a second and see if they take on. It's got a fire on board, which is always a huge plus, right? But 6 knots, it's not like we can't surface and use the deck gun, but gotta get better with the torpedoes, man. I've been stinking it up. First one was, at least I realized where the mistake was. It didn't help me much with letting them time compress move forward again. I should have paid closer attention to what angle they were. They were still a ways off. We had time to just sit and let them move before making the calculations. I think we could have got her had we not. Yeah, it's taking the health down. Might be a little crippled. Fire on board, but they haven't abandoned yet. Surely they've taken on water and we'll go down. I think even, yeah, it's yep, health went away. Let's go ahead and surface. That was kind of a 50-50. Slight confidence booster with the TDC, but also definitely realized where the mistake was. That's all right. You gotta learn. What we will do is head towards them just a tad. See what they have going on. Delete some of this chaos here before it clutters up the map. Yeah, I think I'm gonna keep forcing myself to use the TDC when possible, when stuff's not super chaotic, because number one, I like the mod, and number two, it's the only way I'm really gonna learn personally, is like forcing myself to study it up a bit, practice. Let's go ahead and
Herr Kaloy.
Yeah, I don't think I mean, if I were you, Jet, the way you guys are pretty experienced with it, I would just use that TDC. Like, just start with it. It's literally just a different interface, that's all. You guys would have that down in, like, a single play session. You'd know exactly what you're doing in no time. So we can get close enough to interact with the old lifeboats. There we go. officers. This guy, I'm pretty sure, was the one we had kind of goofed early on in terms of trying to get positioned correctly, so I'm just going to go ahead and move a bit. Auto save. I'm going to move a bit. I'll probably call her there for the evening. It's pretty late. A little practice for once with the TDC, so that'll help me out tremendously. Let's check the old fuel. Guys are good. Just move out of that range so we get away from that wreckage and the lifeboats. No need. All right, I think we're gonna call her there for the night. I appreciate you hanging out and chat for sure. We had some other people in here tonight, but everybody was pretty quiet. So just you and I riding shotgun there. Appreciate you. Have a good holiday weekend if I don't see you. So I might be around, but you never know what you get into with this weather. So enjoy your weekend. We'll catch you later, buddy. Thank you.